have divided my presentation into the two parts. In first part, we will see what this DICE is, what we have achieved. And in the second part, we will explore possibilities of your involvement in this huge exercise, which is perhaps the largest in the world. We have already covered 15,18,160 schools from across 36 states and union territory of our country. We received data none less than from 7,500 blocks spread over 70,000 clusters from all over the country. I will give you all the details. Why we have started this? In 94-95, we launched, our country launched District Primary Education Program. And at that time, it was realized that the country is not in a position to undertake, implement, and monitor District Primary Education Program. So the Government of India has realized that let there be a computerized educational management information system with school as the unit of data collection and district as the unit of data dissemination. And the responsibility to develop such a computerized educational management information system was given to then NIPA, National Institute of Educational Planning, which has now become National University of Educational Planning and Administration. We joined hands with UNICEF. UNICEF is supporting this project since inception, and we also joined hands with the Ministry of Human Resource Development. So in 94-95, we designed and developed a data capture format in consultation with all the stakeholders at the national level, at the district level, and also at the state level. Only those variables were kept in the data capture format which has got nationwide implications, which has got implications for all the 35 states of the country. So that data capture format was designed and developed at the national level and implemented in the very first year, 94-95, we could able to cover about 65,000 schools. But that was limited only to the DPEP states. 42 DPEP districts and 7 DPEP states was covered in the very first year, but we could able to reach 65,000 schools. By the end of the DPEP, in the year 2000, we could able to reach none less than 18 states and 272 districts. But still, we were confined only to the DPEP districts. There were large number of other non-DPEP states and districts, they were not covered under this one. So by the end of DPEP in 2001, we could able to reach 272 districts. And in the year 2001, the Government of India, they have launched Elementary Education for All program, which is known as Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program. They have realized the importance of timely availability of the statistics and decided that let the DICE spread over the entire country. That was the year 2001. But at the same time, it was also decided that let the scope of DICE is also expanded from earlier primary level of education to the entire elementary level of education, covering both primary, that is up lower primary 1 to 5 classes, as well as upper primary 6 to 8 classes, all together 1 to 8 classes. In our country, it is known as the elementary level of education. So that was in the year 2001. We have started working and started trying to cover the entire country under the DICE, but we have taken 5 years to reach the every nook and corner of our country. And it was the first year, in the year 2005-06, that we could able to cover all the 35 states and union territory of our country, and we could reach 604 districts and none less than 1.04 million institutions imparting elementary level of education. That was the first year. Since 2005-06, we have traveled a lot. We have achieved a lot. Lot of awards are given to our work, which NUPA has initiated across the country. 4 national awards, e-governance, e-India award, Manthan South Asia award, EMPI Indian Innovation Award, all these awards are there. So I will give you more details first and let's see what are the challenges still we have to meet. Then, in the year 2007-8, keeping in view the importance of timely availability of the statistics, the government of India has further decided that let the scope of DICE is expanded from elementary level of education to the secondary and higher secondary level of education, and that responsibility was also given to NUPA. In 2007-8, we have designed and developed online software for secondary and higher secondary level of education, which till recently was known as SEMIS, Secondary Education Management Information System, and the elementary level of education management information system is known as District Information System for Education, that is the DICE. So we continued for 5 years. Up to 2011-12, we continued with SEMIS on the one hand to take care of the secondary and higher secondary level of education, and the DICE on the other hand to take care of the requirement of the elementary level of education, to take care of the requirement of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program on the one hand and Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan program on the other hand. But we realized that there is a lot of duplicity of the efforts. On the one hand, we have a school having classes 1 to 12. For 1 to 8 class, we have a separate data capture format. For 9, 10, 11, 12, we have a separate format for that one. One respondent for secondary, one respondent for elementary, one software for elementary, one software for secondary, higher secondary level. This software is offline, this software is online. And for one school having 1 to 12 classes, there are two respondents. There were two unique identification codes. Every school should have only one code. We have given 11-digit school identification code to all the schools. But in that situation, we could have two codes for one school. So there, and MIS in charge for SSA was different, MIS in charge for RMSA was different, this software was different, this software, that software was different. So we realized, and the government of India has also realized, that let us think about unification of the SEMIS and DICE. Unification so as to develop a school education statistical system for the entire school education sector. So a committee was formed under the chairmanship of the Vice Chancellor NUPA, and that committee suggested that let us have a unified school education statistical system. That was the year, perhaps in the year 11, it was decided. So for the year 2012-13, we unified both DICE and SEMIS. But before that, we already experimented at our own in Pondicherry and in West Bengal successfully, having one data capture format for the entire school education. Very successfully it was achieved. For the year, from the year 12-13, we have decided at the national level, let there be only one data capture format. So we have one data capture format now. It was also decided that let there be only one software. Now there is only one software for both secondary and higher secondary level of education. It was decided that the data entry will take place from the office of the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program, because they have got very vast experience. So the data entry is still taking place in the office of the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan program. It was also decided that let there be only one nodal officer looking after both secondary as well as elementary MIS. So we now have one. And all the schools now, all the 1.5 million schools are now having only one data capture format and one software and one nodal agency. That is, since 2012-13, DICE is now known as UDICE, Unified District Information System for Education, because it is a unification of the secondary and the elementary management information system. When we designed and when we implemented Unified DICE in the year 2012-13, lot of problems, lot of music we have faced. Because it was decided that the data entry will take place in the office of the SSA. And one other important thing here in our system is that when we print the data capture format, our data capture format is printed from the software from across the country, including 48 schools Lakshadweep is having and 240,000 schools the Uttar Pradesh is having. All the data capture formats are printed from the software itself. And the beauty of the system is that when we print the data capture format from the software, the previous year data is printed. All the constant variables, name of the school, school identification code, management, school category, when it was established, whether it is located in the rural area, urban area, such variables which never change, they all are pre-printed. Practically, only one column under the banner of enrollment is not pre-printed. Otherwise, the teacher's table is also printed. And in many schools where the teachers are 50, 100, it is very difficult to update the information. Every time it is not good that they fill in the information every time afresh. So the data capture format is pre-printed. All the information, constant information is pre-printed. So it was decided that the data capture format will be printed in the office of the Service Exam Abhiyan program, and data entry will also take place in the office of the SSA. The role of RMSA was to distribute the form, check the form and all. But somehow the message was delivered at the grassroots level that UDICE is the baby of Service Exam Abhiyan program. It is not, ye hamara kaam nahi hai. This is the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan walon ka kaam hai. This message was delivered. And this has created problems also across the country. But 17 or 18 states which have a joint or the common state project directors for both SSA and RMSA, we did not face any problem. But in the first year, yes, the problems were faced. Then in the second year, 13, 14, absolutely we did not face any problem. It was quite smooth. Very smooth across the country. And in the 14-15 right now is going on. Till yesterday evening we have already received data none less than 30 states out of 36 states. We are now waiting for the remaining 6 states. This is just a miracle. Earlier the data time lag in data collection and data dissemination was 7 to 8 years. It has now come down to less than a year at the national level and only a few months at the state and the district level. And you will happy to know that all our 15-16 annual work plan, both under SSA and RMSA, they are exclusively based on the data of 14-15. DICE has completely eradicated time lag in availability of the statistics. DICE has constituted MIS unit not only state and the district level but also at the block level, and there is no data gaps now. Whatever data is required is available in ready to use form. All data which we have is available at a disaggregated level, from school to cluster to block to district, state, and also at the national level. Data is available freely without any cost, without any problem, and it is available in the public domain. So, what specifically we have done, let us first see that one. Data capture format is designed and developed at the national level. Only those variables are kept which has got nationwide implications for all the 36 states. But it is not that the state, because there are many programs which are going on which are state specific. The state has given full freedom to add n number of additional and supplementary variables. And they have all added. But the beauty of the system is that by using the same software, they can manipulate, enter the data and generate a report on additional variables also. There is no need of any additional software. The same UDICE software can be used even on the supplementary variables. One of the other important reasons of our success, we treat it as a successful experiment, is that everything is designed and developed in-house at NUPA without spending a single penny. The software, our software, is designed and developed, is now user-friendly, well-tested, error-free, menu-driven, with limited or no scope for manipulation. The software is designed and developed in NUPA itself. Otherwise, the other education software, just for example, the All India Education Survey conducted by NCERT, they paid 4 crore rupees. For All India Education Survey, they paid 1 crore 20 lakh rupees. And they are always dependent on the third party agency which is given the responsibility to develop the software. For minor changes, boys, if you want, in place of boy, you need to go to NIC. to get it reflected in the. We are not dependent on all these issues. On day-to-day basis, we are changing, modifying our software as and when such request is received from the our users from the block level, district level, state level, and the national level. So we have achieved a lot, but still we have to achieve a lot more. Our data is very comprehensive. The facility-related variables, all the variables. Be it is the drinking water, boundary wall, number of teachers, toilets, boys, girls' toilets, electricity, whether the school is having computer or functional computer or computer-aided learning, boys enrollment, girls enrollment, SC enrollment, ST enrollment, OBC enrollment, minority enrollment, religious enrollment by different religions other than Muslim is also available. This is available for secondary, this is available for higher secondary, grade-wise enrollment, grade-wise repeaters, SC enrollment, grade-wise, ST enrollment, grade-wise, and all other facilities. And we are also maintaining a comprehensive profile of 7.2 million teachers. You name the variable, that variable is available in ready-to-use form so far as the DICE is concerned. It is available. We, on the one year data, we used to bring out 11 publications. All these publications are available in the public domain at DICE.in, D-I-S-E.in. All our publications, about 65 publications since 2001-2002 is available in ready-to-use form at DICE.in, D-I-S-E.in. But these are the printed ones, or many of these now have become the web-enabled publications. The PDF forms are of no use to friends like you. Ab PDF ka kya karenge? Gali denge hame? Ke kya PDF de diya yaar? Kya kare kya? For people like you, what we have done? We have another website which is known as schoolreportcards.in. Schoolreportcards.in. This website is the winner of four national awards which I have mentioned earlier. Here you will get the report card of each and every school. Each and every means 1.5 million schools. You can see report cards on more than 500 variables, not only for the year 2014-15, but for the last 10 years. Since 2005-06, you can see the report cards of each and every school and a separate report card for the RTE report, Right to Education report card. You can see. All are available in the public domain. We have also given the ranking, RT ranking, of each and every school. That you can also see. You can see these report cards in English, Hindi, Kannada, and four or five other regional languages.
What is the actual URL?
Schoolreportcards.in. You just write schoolreportcards.in. So that is also available in the public domain, separately for boys and separately for secondary and elementary school. And all the schools which are covered under DICE, we collect data from all type of school having classes 1 to 12. With irrespective of type of school, category of school, like category means only primary, only upper primary, primary plus upper primary, primary, upper primary, secondary, upper primary, secondary, higher secondary. There are 11 categories are there. Then the school type, boys, co-educational, and girls' school, and then the school by management. Lot of management are there, Department of Education, private aided and all. So whatever we have, so the school report card is already made available in the public. But one can see the school report card only of a current year. If you want to see the progress of the same school, you need to go to the back previous year. That is, again, you will fight with me that what is this nonsense? If we want to see the progress of the school, how can we see the progress? So these limitations are there, and that is why we have presented under the schoolreportcards.in a provision to download the data. Whatever we have in our server located at the National University of Educational Planning and Administration, you can also download that. We have developed our own data center. And I'm happy to report you that our websites are always on. They were never down for the last 2.5 years. Jab dusre logon ke upar nirbhar karte the, to bahut problem thi humko. Now we do not face any problem. Everything is managed in-house. We are not dependent on anyone. Earlier, our servers were located in USA. If you want to have the crystal report, first we have to approach the local vendor. Then he will approach this. Then the server will refresh. It will take 2-3 days. Now we are not dependent on anyone. We are managing all our websites in-house and beautifully managing. So what we have done? We have provided downloading of the raw data. But for school report guys.in, for dice.in, you need not any registration. But for downloading of the data from the school report guys.in, you need your email, we need your email, and the purpose or how you are going to use this one. And within next 24 hours, the approval is granted, it is approved for 21 days. So 7,500 users from across the world, they have registered with us. All of these users are not serious. But some of them are very serious, exclusively working on the DICE data. Many of them are. We have a separate channel on DICE.in where the use of DICE data, we try to collect all these collections. You just see, large number of PhD scholars in India and also outside India, in Stanford, Cambridge, Oxford, Jawaharlal Nehru University, Delhi University, Raipur University, they are exclusively working on the DICE data. Our philosophy at the NUPA is that nobody should come to NUPA physically to collect the data. Whosoever come, no need to come. If you want to discuss the issues, come. If you have come to collect the data, please don't come. We will provide you online through email. No need to come. Data is not personal property. We are of the view that data is for the users, like you and thousands of other users across the world. It is your property. We are only the custodian. So NUPA is the custodian of your data. We have achieved this much, but there are many problems. Everything is not good. Everything is not fine. Continuing the reliability and quality of data is an area of concern. Quality cannot improve overnight. It is a slow process. It will take its own time. But if you see our data now and 5 years back, you will appreciate that there is a lot of improvement in the quality, consistency, coverage, utilization, sharing, and dissemination of the data. Lot of improvement has taken place, but there are many challenges out there. Now I focus some of these challenges where you can also contribute. I have said that we have covered 160 schools during the year 2013-14. We do not know what is the percentage of this coverage. Because we do not have the school directory maintained by the schools. There is no directory maintained by the schools. We do not know how many schools are there. But we firmly believe that almost all the government and aided schools have already been covered. And more than 350,000 private schools, including private aided and unaided, they are also covered. About 22,000 unrecognized schools have also been covered. But we do not know what is the percentage of coverage because the states do not update or do not maintain the school directory. The school directory is nothing but the listing of all the schools which is imparting school education from grade 1 to 12 by management, by type, by category like that. That list is not readily available. People used to say earlier that DICE is, we cannot believe DICE. Because the private school to data nahi deta hai. The situation is now totally, completely changed. Private school is now coming forth and provide the data. It has become because of the fact that in many states, it has been made mandatory for schools to have an 11-digit ID code. Otherwise, this state board affiliation will be taken off. In Karnataka, in Tamil Nadu, in Assam, in many other states, it is made mandatory for all the schools, including private aided and unaided, that please bring your DICE code. So that is how the private schools have also joined this unified DICE. I do not know whether you are aware or not. In Karnataka, most of people are from Karnataka, Bangalore. Yes. All of a sudden, I started receiving calls from the parents What is this you guys? We started receiving calls from this Judge Dahan. Sir, do you have any branch outside Karnataka, India, Delhi? क्या क्या हो गया भैया जस्ट डायल हमें क्यों पूछ रहा है ऑल ऑफ द सडन वी हैव कम टू नो दैट दिस ईयर इन कर्नाटका द 25% रिजर्वेशन कोटा ईडब्ल्यूएस कोटा इज ऑनलाइन सिस्टम एंड द पेरेंट्स आर सेंड एसएमएस दैट योर चाइल्ड इज एडमिशन इज प्रोवाइडेड इन दिस स्कूल हैविंग दिस डाइस कोड दे डू नॉट नो व्हाट इज दिस डाइस कोड दे अप्रोच जस्ट डायल Just dial approach does. This is how people are getting more and more involved in the unified DIS. Now the private schools, they are also coming forth. They are ready to provide the data. So the first important, still, we do not believe, claim that all the private schools are covered. Maybe a few private schools and also a few government schools like Kendri Vidyalaya. Tibetan school, Navodaya Vidyalaya, Sainik school, tribal school, this school might not have been covered under DIS. So first important help, your contribution we are now looking is that you kindly ensure that all the uncovered schools are covered under the DIS. You are working at the grassroots level, you know better than us, and we have a channel on our website to report the missing school. Hundreds of schools are reported by the users like you, that I know this is school in Bangalore, in rural Bangalore, in this block, near the temple, but this is not included in the DIS covered, so they just reported. We take up the list of the schools which are reported by the users to the state project director with the request that kindly ensure that these schools are covered during the next collection. So first important thing is the covering the uncovered school. So we are quite confident that almost all the schools are covered. But still we have to make an additional effort to ensure that let there be no uncovered school so far as the school education is concerned. Ek cheez main aapko aur batana chahunga. Keeping in view all the developments, keeping in view the success of DIS, the government of India has now decided that all parallel collection of information system will be stopped, abandoned, and DIS will be the only source of information. Which means that DIS has acquired the status of official statistics. All the publications of MHRD from the year 2012-13 will be entirely based upon the DIS. You can just see the school education statistics available at MHRD, which is almost based on the DIS only, so far as the school education is concerned. So on the one hand, DIS has become the official statistic. 5 minutes here. Itna bade kaam ko 5 minutes mein kaise ho sakta hai? Fill up the form carefully. This question was also raised in the very first lesson. We are trying our level best to reach our respondents through EduSet, through Gyan Darshan and all. But that is not sufficient. You can also contribute capacity building of the school headmaster, CRC and BRC, and how to get the reliable data, correct data, optimal data, and the full data. Many times what happens, the headmaster used to fill up the form without any referring to the school record. We are now in the process of ensuring that each and every column is filled in, referred to some records which are maintained in the school. So we want to ensure that all the, we have developed 17 core set of records and ensure that all these records are uniformly maintained across the country. It is not a simple task. But many states, they have assured us that yes, it, we will explore possibility of implementing and ensuring that there is core set of records. The third important thing is that our software is offline right now, but it can be used online also, semi-online mode. We are looking for you to kindly give us the online software. Explore some possibility and develop the online software which can be used in the mobile or which can be used by using the laptop or any other device. We are looking for at you. Kindly give us some help in this regard. Then data is available. Disaggregated data is available. Cluster, district, state, national level, everywhere. But where is the utilization? This data is not meant only to develop annual plans. Let us, all the users, come forward. This data is also available to you. I can assure you, everyone sitting here, is that this is your property and we will be not failing in providing you the raw data, I am talking about the school-wise data. The school-wise data is available for everyone sitting here. If you have problem in downloading from the website, you can just write the mail to us. We will always help you. Then the mobile applications. We have developed two mobile applications. We are not technocrats like you. बहुत limited technology है हमारे पास में, but उसी से ये सारा show manage कर रहे हैं. One web app, ASK file, PK file कौन सा होता है?
Google.
That file we have developed. It is not yet registered. You just download from the our website schoolreportcast.in. It will icon will come. School report cards. This is the school finder. Wherever you are in the field, you just insert your pin code. All the schools under that pin code covered under the dice will be displayed. You click that button, then the school report card will also display. That is one. The second one is that if you want to compare a school over a period of time, so the compare a school, the another APK is also there. You can download that one. But they are not very technically sound applications. We are looking at you. And the third important, next important thing is that we want you to develop some apps so that it can be used by the users. अभी थोड़ा मुश्किल है. हर आदमी नहीं कर सकता raw data पे काम. It's very difficult. I cannot do. If you know the SPSS or Strata or other software, then only you will able to play with the raw data. But everyone is not a statistician. Everyone is not computer programmer. Everyone is not having expertise in using the SPSS like that one. Kindly apply your hands so and give us some application so that it can be used. Data is, utilization is not optimal. There is a challenge there. Even though the all annual plans are based on the DICE data, but that will not serve the purpose. Data is very huge in the nature. Very huge. For the last 10 years, data is available. Very comprehensive data is available. We are looking all of at all of you. Kindly come us and join hands in further strengthening the educational management information system in our country. There are many areas where we can work together. There are many areas. The capacity building. Capacity building of not only headmaster respondents in filling up the form, but the capacity building of those who are given responsibility to develop annual plans at the cluster level, block level, and the district level. Despite all our achievements, abhi nahi kar sakte wo. They are unable to handle this data. They are unable to compute gross enrollment ratio, net enrollment ratio, dropout rate, promotion rate, repetition rate, transition rate, completion rate, graduation rate. Unko nahi aata ye sab. Kindly come and have some expertise, your expertise, and decentralize this expertise even to the grassroots levels, and we are looking all of you. And if that is done, we are quite confident, and we also believe that if the data is optimally disseminated, the chances are that it will be utilized. And if it is utilized, the chances will be raised about the quality and consistency of the data. That is only, there is no shortcut method but to further improve the quality of our data. And also the quality of education. You know, quality of education. We have achieved a lot. All the children are in the system, but about 4.5% children of 134 million between 2012-13 and 13-14, they just dropped out from the system. The transition rate is only 80%. The retention rate is only 85%. Lot of loss is going on every year in terms of the dropout and all. And eventually those who retain in the system, they do not complete grade 5. Those who complete grade 5, they do not transit to the grade 6. Those who remain in the grade 6, they do not complete grade 8. Those who complete grade 8, uske baad mein unko padhna likhna kuch nahi aata. Ye sab kaun karega? Used 4 years back, 5 years back, people used to say that, hum kya karein sir? 8 years old data hai, how can we plan? Now the data, there is no time lag. Sir, data is not available on many aspects. Data is available on every aspect now. Sir, paisa nahi hai. Lot of money is there in SSA. But we are failed to utilize the paisa. We are utilizing money, expending, investing it on developing the boundary wall, additional classroom, hand pump, toilet for girls, toilet for boys. And only 23% of schools are having computers. All these computers are not functional. Many schools do not have the electricity. Little less than 50% in school have the electricity. वो कब electricity आती है वो तो भगवान को ही पता है. So we are not ready for all these technical education through the technology. Because large number of schools do not have any facilities. You just visit. In the last 3 months, I visited 18 states. The situation is very disappointing. Very, very disappointing. You just see, the government schools are meant only for the poor. The SC children. The ST children. Kaun sa bachche hai wo? General class ka, there is no child. No child in most of the states in government schools from the and we have given lot of responsibility to SMC. SMC, you know, school management committee. Lot of responsibilities are given. But they have failed to contribute significantly so far as the government schools are concerned. Every January, you see a well-known organization come out with the achievement levels, story about achievement level. But yeah, hamein pata hai yaar. हमारे बच्चों को पढ़ना लिखना नहीं आ रहा है. देर इज प्रॉब्लम इन आवर सिस्टम. दे आर अनेबल टू रीड एंड राइट एज पर द मिनिमम लेवल्स ऑफ लर्निंग. लेकिन हर इन एवरी जनवरी 15 और 16 जनवरी एवरी ईयर यू कम विद द फाइंडिंग दैट द गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में पढ़ना लिखना नहीं आता है. भैया क्या सारी गवर्नमेंट स्कूल खराब है क्या? नहीं है. सारी प्राइवेट स्कूल अच्छा है क्या? वो भी नहीं है. बट एक ऐसा कैंपेन पूरे भारत में चला दिया गया है जिससे ये चलता है ऑल गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स आर बोगस. भैया मैं तो ये कहता हूं जो भी ये सर्वे कर रहे हैं, व्हाई डोंट यू एडॉप्ट 500 स्कूल्स एंड 5000 चिल्ड्रन, टेक इट फ्रॉम 5 years. हमें बताओ कि देखे इनको पढ़ना लिखना हमने सिखा दिया है, आप ये मॉडल फॉलो करो, हम करेंगे उसको. लेकिन ये एवरी जनवरी इफ यू कम विद द फाइंडिंग दैट द लर्निंग ability to read and write of children is not satisfactory, is not acceptable. आप करके दिखाओ ना फील्ड में. सारे सरकारी आप सब तो मुझे नहीं पता, मैं और राजा राम साहब और बहुत सारे लोग यहाँ पे बैठे हैं, they all are the product of the government schools only. So all government schools, एक माहौल पूरे भारत में ऐसा बना दिया है कि government schools are unrepairable. ऐसा नहीं है. Many government schools, many teachers, अभी आप if you analyze the board results, merit कहाँ से आता है? सब रूरल एरिया से आता है. कहाँ से आता है? मोस्ट ऑफ दीज आर द गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स. सो इट इज नॉट दैट ऑल गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स आर ऑफ नो यूज.
मोस्ट ऑफ आवर पेरेंट्स स्टडीड इन गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स.
सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स. आई हैव मिस्ड मेनी पॉइंट्स बिकॉज शी हैज गिवन मी सिग्नल टू 2 मिनट्स. सो आई लॉस्ट.